Hi, hello, very good morning one and all. Welcome to India's largest live learning platform, GradeUp. GradeUp है तो सही प्रप है तो लाइफ सेट है. Welcome to Capsule series. Today, Capsule in Computer Organization and Architecture is How does hard disk function? Okay, so without any delay, let us get into the session. This is quick introduction about me. You may join my Telegram group to interact with me, ask your doubts and know all my class information. Now, we have discussed already in the first capsule different types of memory. If you remember, if you have missed it, please do refer capsule 1 for different types of memory. What are different types of computer memory? The basic classification is internal memory and external memory. Internal memory, which is inside the processor, has two forms, registers and level 1 cache memory. External memory, which is outside the processor, has four forms. What are they? L2 and L3 cache, primary memory, secondary memory and flash memory. Secondary memory is what classified into tapes and disks. So our today's concept, disk, hard disk, is a kind of secondary memory. So why this is called secondary memory? Because it is always additional, optional for the CPU to function. Main memory is mandatory. So it is always secondary for the CPU, hence that name. And it is also known as auxiliary storage or backup storage. It is excessive memory. It is used for the safe copy, right? And when we say disks, these are randomly accessible. Randomly accessible means here semi-random access. It's not pure or full random access. What does this means? Any content can be accessed without any order, but not in the same time. Some content may take less time, some content may take more time to access. So this is semi-random access. And there are three forms of disks. What are they? Floppy disk, optical disk, magnetic disk. Floppy disk used to be available in three different dimensions: 8 inch, 5.25 inch, 3.5 inch. In 8 inch floppy, 1000 kilobyte memory can be stored. In 5.25 inch floppy, 1.21 MB memory can be stored. In 3.5 inch floppy, 1.44 MB can be stored. And what are optical disks? CD, DVD and Blu-ray disks are optical disks. And what is magnetic disk? This is what? Hard disk. So hard disk other name is, technical name is magnetic disk. So let's see how this hard disk internal structure looks like. So this is the internal structure of the hard disk. Observe, we have the circular plate called platter, and all these platters are mounted on the spindle. All these plates are mounted one over the other. This central location is called spindle. Under the spindle we will have a motor called spindle motor. This is spindle. And what are these are all platters. And each platter will have two recording surfaces, both on the bottom, on the top. For every platter, on the top side and on the other side also, data can be recorded. And every surface is partitioned into, every surface, the top surface as well as the bottom surface, every surface is partitioned into tracks. Tracks are further partitioned into what? Sectors. And through what the data is read or written? Through read write head. So this is read write head, and read write head is attached to the read write axis or actuator. Okay, so these are the connections, power supply and all. So mainly look at this. I'll explain how it works in a moment. Before that, these are the courses for 2022 and 2023 ESE and GATE aspirants. For CSE students, GATE in both English and Hindi medium, and these are what you will get in every course. So you will be getting everything, even more than required to crack your GATE. So take super subscription to get the lectures from the expert faculty, who are all very well experienced, knowledgeable and trained many students and helped in reaching their goals. Okay, now, so how hard disk function? As we have seen the diagram, inside the hard disk we have a circular plate mounted over the spindle. The surface is partitioned into tracks. Each track is further partitioned into sectors, isn't it? Now, will every track has same number of sectors or different? So that depends on, two design criteria. There are two design models for the hard disk. One is CLV design, other is CAV design. Constant linear velocity, constant angular velocity. What they are, how they differ, that we will see in another capsule. So based on this, whether every track has same number of sectors or different number of sectors depends. Now for the disks, this is for disks. Now for the hard disk, constant angular velocity works where we have different density with the same number of sectors in every track. Every track will have same number of sectors. How that is possible? By varying the density. So in the inner track the density is more, or in the outer track the density is more? Definitely the innermost track has, the innermost track has high recording density. Right. Now, how much can be accessed at a time from a sector? From a hard disk, one sector can be accessed at a time. One sector only can be accessed. Now, how that sector is identified? That is what our capsule for. How the sectors are numbered and how that sector address will be, that we will see in the next capsule. Before that, today, if you observe, here we are having the read-write head. The read-write head is here. So this is read-write head for us. This read-write head, once the axis is positioned, it can access exactly half track sectors, means half disk it can access. It can access. So a read-write head, once positioned, it can access half track, that means half surface. Right. But what if the required sector is on the other half? On the other half of the surface. I mean, if the required sector is in this half, directly once we place the head, it can access. But my point is, what if the required sector is on the other half, in the other half area? This axis cannot stretch. So what should happen? Disk rotation should happen. So what should happen? The disk has to rotate. So for this rotation, we are having a motor under the spindle, that is called spindle motor. So I am taking a spindle. This is the top surface. Bottom surface, surface 3, surface 4, like this. Okay, so these two together, one platter. These two together, one platter. Okay, and this is the surface 0, this is the surface 1, this is the surface 2, this is the surface 3. Now, if the read-write head is positioned once, it can access half track. If the required sector is on the other half, disk rotation happens. But now we will get a doubt. What if the required sector is on the bottom surface, or surface 2, or surface 3, means somewhere in the middle or in the last? this how this axis can get into in between these surfaces. That's why, that is the reason why every surface has its own read write head. Each surface has its own read write head. So number of surfaces will be equal to number of heads. Not every platter has one head, every surface has one head. That means every platter will have two heads. Understood? So our read write logic, which is here, where the read write logic will be. So here we have read write logic. This is called controller. So this read write logic will give the signal to the read write head about which sector it wants to access. How that signal will be, how it will give the identification for the sector, that is what capsule 4. So once the identification for the sector is given to head, head will position based on the surface, its respective read write axis and head will work. If rotation is needed, disk rotation happens and the head is positioned. Either it will read the data or write the data. So this is how the read write happens from the hard disk. Got it? I believe now you got better idea how hard disk one sector is accessed. Access may be read access or write access. Both we can say access. Okay, so let's see how a sector is identified with the number and address, how this numbering and addressing differs in the next capsule tomorrow. Till then, have a great day. And this is our GradeUp Gate Hall of Fame. In 2021, we have 100 plus GradeUp students under 100 in Gate 2021. And under top 10, we have 10 plus gradients. So take super subscription without any delay and access all the structured live courses. Also get the green card access. Thank you so much for watching this. And you may join my Telegram group for contacting me, ask your doubts or anything. Thank you. Before you leave, don't forget to like the session, share it, and subscribe to our GradeUp Gate channel. Thank you. Have a great day. Bye-bye.